Listen to me. If you learn to pray, you will walk on what others are sinking in. Oh, I feel it. I said, if you learn to pray, you will walk on what others are sinking in. When you learn to pray, you will win on what is defeating other people. When you learn to pray, you will laugh over what is making others cry. When people are crying, today, America, a lot of people are crying out of fear. But when you are a prayer warrior, you are not afraid of anything. Is somebody hearing me? The Bible says in the book of Psalms, Psalm 94, verse number 20, he said that there are people that devise iniquity by law. And sometimes human beings that are elected can devise iniquity by law. But the Bible says that such iniquity shall have no fellowship with the throne of God. So when you stand before God Almighty, like the children of Israel, the more they afflicted them, the more they grew and they became powerful. Let me tell you something. Kingdoms will rise and kingdoms will go, but the prayer warrior stands forever in the Lord Jesus Christ. Let politicians rise, but politicians will go, because they only solicit for votes every 4 years. But let me submit to you about somebody. He is not a politician. He doesn't canvass for votes. He doesn't go to caucuses. All he does is that he sits upon the circle of the earth and he does that which pleases him. And let me tell you something. We are under a new covenant. The Bible says that it is established upon better promises, obtained through a more excellent ministry. I'm talking about Hebrews 8 and 6. And that covenant is your covenant. And you can walk in it and no human being can do anything against you. Let me tell you, whatever plans that they have to use iniquity against you, when you learn to stand before God, you become fearless. You become courageous, because you know that no matter what it is, no human being can take you out. Let me submit to you that we are a people and we are wonderful. When they were all encamped in the place of Moab, and they were about to go into their promised land, and the enemy nations were afraid, Balak the king went and he called Balaam and said, come and curse the people for me. And 7 times he tried to curse them, but the Bible says that the Lord turned it into a blessing. Any curse that they are trying to curse you, may God turn it into a blessing. Is somebody hearing me? He said, I've not observed iniquity in Jacob, and who can curse whom the Lord has not cursed? And he said, I look at them. He stood there and he began to prophesy. He said, they are like a lion, and who can rouse them from sleep? Let me tell you, there's a lion on the inside of you, and your enemies must be afraid to awaken you, because when you wake up, you will roar, and the Lord roars, and who can stand? Is somebody hearing me? There is a lion on the inside of you. Stop running away like a pigeon. Stop running away like a mouse, and stand tall and know that God is with you, and when God is with you, nothing can take you. Balaam saw it and said, who can arouse them? In the sense that he even said, let me die the death of the righteous, because the people have no army, the people have no weapons, the people have no strategy, but God Almighty is in the midst of them, and the shout of the king was with them. Let me tell you something, I can boast about this God, because the shout of the king is in our midst. We have no power against these people, we have no authority against the people, but our hope is in the Most High God. He alone can fight for you. He alone can do things that are unusual. And in this year of the unusual, may God cause you to dance publicly and not care who watches you. May God do some supremely intelligent things for you, that people will stand back and say, I thought I knew you, but now I realize I don't know you at all. That is the kind of God that you and I serve. May God this year invade your space and prove to your enemies that he's closer to you even than the shirt on your back. May God prove to your enemies that you may be small, but in the spirit you are powerful. You may look weak, but in the spirit you are great.